Okay, great to be part of this meetup, and of course I definitely hope to see you in more than 40 days on the conference on the 6th and the 7th of October. My name is Art Kramer, and maybe you are asking yourself, what is he doing in this outfit? There's a very simple reason for that. I am ready to go to my training session, because in my free time, I'm an assistant volleyball coach of a team in the highest competition level of the Netherlands. And because sport is all about focusing and improving continuously, I am also took some lessons in sports psychology. And the things I learned in sports psychology were so interesting, and they're also very interesting for software testers. Because you also want to be the best in software testing, don't you? So how can you apply sports psychology in software testing? Because that's what I'm going to tell you, because it's very important that you can make a difference, because you should be aware of your mental capabilities. That's what we learn in sports psychology. And because we live in a world where there's a lot of diversion, a lot of screens, people are constantly distracted by all kinds of things, you should be able to make a difference to become a better software tester. And I think sports psychology can help you out on that. So I'm going to, at the conference, I'm going to tell you more about the test flow, and the flow refers to your mental capabilities, such as concentration, motivation, arousal. Those are the things that can help you to improve yourself, and I'm going to tell you more about, and also how you can apply them in software testing, how you can apply them during session-based testing. So that is what I'm going to talk about in my keynote on the conference on the 6th and 7th October. And besides that, I'm also going to give a workshop about nudging. And nudging is how can external variables help you to get something done in a nice, positive way. And the best example I can give is mostly what you see sometimes in toilets is the little fly where you have to pee. That's something that helps you to aim correctly, at least for men. And it's also a way how you can influence people, because the fly in the toilet helped meant that you don't have to pay a lot of money for cleaning up the toilets. So nudging is about how to influence each other. And I think software testers should be able to influence their environment. So during the workshop, we are going to look how can we influence our environments, people around us, how to improve our testing. And a simple example I can give is how can we help the people in our teams to improve our risk analysis? Because that's just quite abstract how you do a good risk analysis, and maybe we can help them by a little nudging how we can do a better analysis on risks. So that's a topic I want to discuss with you during a workshop, and we have to be very creative in that workshop to think about how we can influence people around us. So these are just two things I'm going to do. I'm going to give a keynote about the test flow, how sports psychology will help you out in improving as a software tester. And besides that, I'm going to give you a workshop about nudging, how nudging can help you to influence the surroundings around you. So I definitely hope to see you on the 6th and 7th of October at that conference, and hope to see you there and have a good conversation together.
Okay, thank you very much for your words, and we will see you at the conference. Bye.
Yeah, definitely. Bye-bye.